Hi, I'm Tim McCurry with ReadyArc. I'm one of the welding automation specialists. Today we're going to go through setting up the Miller ArcReach SuitCase 12 to the Miller Big Blue 400 Pro. First, let's start with the ArcReach SuitCase 12. I'm going to open up the suitcase. In here we have a couple different parts. We have this volt sensing lead. This is not a ground for your welding machine. This sends feedback to the drive motor here in the suitcase feeder. This needs to be attached to your workpiece, but not necessarily the ground. Here we have our locking ring for our welding spool. We have our drive motor for our drive rolls. We have our idler for our idler roll. We have a tensioner to tension the rolls between the wire, and we have a wire straightener. I'll now start setting up the wire. First, I need to install these drive rolls. The drive rolls are specifically machined for the size of the wire you're going to use. This one happens to be for 035 solid wire. They make different wires, and we'll cover that in a minute. When I want to insert these, I'm going to align them with the three points as seen. I'm going to slide them on, and a quarter turn locks it in place. I'll do the same with the upper idler wheel. Once in place, we can start putting the wire on. But first, let's talk about the different wires. The flux cord wire looks different than the solid wire. The reason why is because of the way that it's made. The flux core wire is a flat piece of metal that is formed with a flux on the inside. It does require different drive rolls, and as you can see the difference in the drive rolls, these have serrations along the inside. That is to grab that wire and not crush the wire or crush the flux that's inside the wire. Now we're going to mount our solid wire. The spool has two holes in it that are going to correspond with the arbor and the locating pin inside this feeder. Once the spool is in, return the locking ring to the spool to keep it in place. Now I'm going to remove my wire from the spool, clip off the bent end, feed that wire through the wire straightener and into the gun port. Once I have that located in there, I will close the idler wheel and I will tighten the adjuster. The tension adjuster has several settings on it. You can go looser or tighter. If you over tight the tensioner, it'll crimp the wire and not feed the wire and spin the reels. If it's too loose, the reels will spin because it's not in contact with the wire. So finding the right spot to drive the wire is important. Now I'm going to attach the welding torch or gun. I'm going to insert the wire into the gun tube here. I'm going to check these black O-rings to make sure that they're not worn, cracked, frayed, or broken, as that is our seal for our gas. Once I insert the gun or torch into the housing, I'm going to tighten the knob. I'm then going to attach the trigger switch, which will activate the feeder when I pull my trigger on my torch, my gun. Now that we have that set up, let's talk about setting up our gas. The gas is set up in the back of the machine. So first we're going to set up the gas hose. There is a corresponding port in the back of the suitcase feeder. We're going to insert and tighten the fitting. I now can turn on the gas. This is an Arcal cylinder, so it has a simple lever that I'm going to turn up, and the cylinder is currently on and at full pressure. This specific cylinder has a flow meter on the side. There are different variations of this cylinder. For this particular one, it has a flow meter built in on the side, and I'm going to set it for 35 cubic feet an hour. Now that we're ready to connect the suitcase feeder to the power source, let's start with the cables. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to attach the volt sensing lead to the ground cable in order to give the suitcase power. Remember, the ground needs to be attached to the work. This is not your ground. Once attached, I'll lower that out of the way, and then I will attach the cable. The ground goes into the negative side. And now we'll attach our positive side. To the welding machine. Once our positive side is attached, we'll make the final connection to the welding machine. The positive lead to the power input on the back of the suitcase feeder. Now that's fully connected, we can run through the starting of the power source. Starting of the power source, we have our on-off switch. We have a preheater. We have a remote for 14-pin connection. We have a dial that is for used in other operations. We have our selector switch. We have our 240 50 amp auxiliary power. We have our 110 GFI receptacles, and we have our 110 breaker set. In order to start this system, we're going to turn it to the run position. It will take a minute for the digital display to show, and then we're ready to start. Once started, you will hear the machine drop down and idle. If we come here to the selector switch, we have a couple of different positions we can choose to weld with. We have gas metal arc and flux cord arc, which will be chosen to weld with through the 14-pin connector, which is for other external feeders or spool guns. The next position is the gas metal arc flux cord welding for suitcase type feeders. The position after that is our no gas flux cord arc welding. We'll cover more of that in a little bit. Our next position is the stick welding position for our softer arc welding rods, such as 7018. Our next position is our stick welding position for our 6010 series or our 10 series rod, which uses a stiffer arc. We have a carbon arc gouge setting. We have a lift arc TIG setting. And we have a scratch arc setting. So for this instance, I will turn the dial and put it on the proper setting for gas metal arc flux cord welding. Once that's set, I can now power my feeder on. as my feeder powers on, this type of feeder can be used very remotely. You're able to adjust your wire feed speed and your voltage through the resistor, or through the power that is being conducted through the welding cable. Right now our display shows voltage and wire feed speed. I can make any adjustment at the feeder. What this does, this allows me to be extremely remote, to be further away from my welding power source and still be able to weld and use the feeder. Now I'll take my welding torch or gun. I'll remove the nozzle. And I'll feed wire through. First, there's several switches up here. There's a soft arc switch. There is a constant voltage, constant current switch used in other applications. There is a trigger hold switch. And there is a purge switch, which will allow me to purge gas from my tank. And a jog switch, which will allow me to jog the wire without having to pull the trigger and potentially arc the wire when it comes through. Now that the wire is through, I then can feed my tip back in, as well as my welding nozzle. Close the door to my feeder. When welding with an Innershield wire, that wire has several differences. First, you still need to use the serrated drive rolls as we did before with the flux cord wire. However, you're gonna adapt your gun, and this is a gasless gun. Innershield means gasless. As you can see, there's a difference in the type of gooseneck that we have, as well as protector. This is not so much as a nozzle for shielding gas as it is to give you the proper contact tip to work distance or stick out. The gun is made not to carry gas. And when changing for an Innershield wire, we also have to change our cables on the machine. Some Innershield wires require you to change the polarity of the machine. What we have to do is just simply change our positive and our negative. To change the polarity of our machine for an Innershield or gasless wire. Always check your wire manufacturer's recommendations for what type of polarity needs to be used. Now we're ready to weld, but first I have to put on my some safety gear. So I still need my steel toe boots and my safety glasses, but I'll have to put on my welding jacket, my welding hood, and my welding gloves.